After School Minute, yeah.
Hello and welcome to After School Minute. It's after school history, but only a minute. Today is President's Day. It's also still Black History Month, so I figured we'd talk about the first black man to ever run for president. Cool? Cool. His name was George Edwin Taylor, and he was born in 1857 in Little Rock, Arkansas, to a free mother and enslaved father. He was an activist, abolitionist, and politician who ran for president in 1904 on behalf of the National Negro Liberty Party. He campaigned for universal suffrage, regardless of race, federal anti-lynching laws, and additional black regiments in the United States Army. He knew his candidacy would be viewed as laughable by some. Wait, you're running for president? But you're black. But he believed that a specifically black political party that could get out the black vote was the only way black people could exercise political influence in the United States, especially during a time when states were well-versed in disenfranchising black voters, aka not allowing them to vote. Teeny tiny spoiler, he lost to Teddy Roosevelt. Shocker there. I'm sure it was a steaming pile of racism, the fact that no newspapers supported the National Negro Liberty Party, and the state laws preventing the NLP from listing candidates on election ballots, but, I mean, it could have been something else. Nevertheless, George Edwin Taylor had the courage to stand up for what was right, and he should be commended and remembered. Happy Black History Month. Class dismissed.